Have you ever wondered why there is a great bond between Israel and the US? Or how old are these sentiments? Have you ever wondered what brought the statues of Moses and the Ten Commandments to the US House of Representatives, Supreme Court, and Library of Congress? In 1620, exactly 400 years ago, the Mayflower set out from Britain and landed in Plymouth Rock, Massachusetts, with 102 passengers who considered themselves pilgrims. Inspired by the Old Testament, these pilgrims referred to King James I of England as the modern-day Pharaoh, and their departure from Britain as the modern-day Exodus. For them, their sailing across the Atlantic Ocean was the parting of the sea, and America was the modern-day Promised Land or the New Israel. The perception that they were the modern-day chosen people was what motivated them and their descendants to name their towns, cities, mountains, deserts, national parks and forests by the names of ancient biblical villages and cities. For example, in the US, you can find 18 towns called Jerusalem, 32 by the name of Salem, which is the original biblical name of Jerusalem, 83 towns by the name of Shiloh, where the first tabernacle stood, 34 different locations called Bethel, the house of God in Hebrew, 18 towns called Zion, and the list goes on. In fact, in colonial America, the most widely read book was the Bible. It has inspired the early pilgrims and the founding fathers, teachers, the clergy, political leaders, and the public at large till this current day. The seeds of the special ties between the United States and the Jewish people were sown long before the US Declaration of Independence in 1776 and the founding of the State of Israel in 1948. In this series of videos, we will present the 400 years of the US-Israel nexus and how the bond between the two nations is blossoming and bearing fruit, with its roots extending beyond the political beltway of Washington, D.C., transcending the pertinent role of the Jewish community and eclipsing geostrategic considerations and formal agreements. Together, we will understand how the pro-Israel sentiments are nurtured by an intrinsic sense of affinity between the current Jewish return to the land of Israel, the Holy Land, and the genesis of America.